We are going live. Steve says he's back. We're going to get started in about 15 seconds. Give you guys a chance to get in there, get your fucking popcorn, while I take a quick drink, and get the mic set up. All right, we are good. We are all set up. You know, I always need my freaking Herbalife when we get rolling. Just had to wait for all the channels. We got this going live on 4 different channels, all of our Peak Physique pages, personal pages, all that shit. So I just had to give it a second for everything to click in. And I wanted to get opened up on the tablet here. If you guys have any questions, comments, want to tell me to shut the hell up, whatever you want to say. And we're going to get started. Put that Herbalife down. For some reason, it wasn't clicking on our tablet here. Here we go. So this is Steve Says, episode number 35. So much shit been going on. We've been off with these episodes for a couple of weeks. We are back on today, getting back into it, into the flow. If you've been here before, you know this is all about personal development, peak freak style. This week is episode number 35. Like I said, this show is always about our own personal perspective on personal development, health, fitness, nutrition, and freaking life. It's all about adapting and overcoming, becoming a better version of yourself every freaking day, getting your shit together, stop being a little bitch, and trusting the process, and of course, making no excuses. If you have any questions, comments, you can put them right there. I'm holding this so I can check out what's going on. 1%. It's called get a fucking charger. Rapido. Get a charger. Charge your shit in. Shit is always dead. So, you know, we're getting set up for our grand opening tomorrow. This is not what this is about. Steve Says is all about just making yourself a better version of yourself every day. Basically, in the intro to this, you saw it said, don't be that person. I just mentioned this in yesterday to the VIP members, the group only, and it happened to me less than 12 hours later, a situation that I mentioned. We're going to get into in a second. Don't be one of these people. We're going to go over 3 different types of people, 3 different types, different categories here. I was in the grocery store getting some supplies for the upcoming grand opening events and the celebrations coming up Friday and Saturday. That's tomorrow and Saturday. So I'm cutting through the cold section to get myself some plain Greek yogurts like I do every time I go there. Grab Greek yogurts. You can never have enough of them. Perfect little snack, 15 grams of protein. But the Greek yogurt aisle is opposite the aisle of the bread, the bagels, the cakes, the donuts, the desserts, and all that other fucking nasty blood sugar exploding, fat building, diabetes creating bullshit food. It's in the same aisle with that cold section. So what did I see? And this is not the first time this has happened. This has actually happened more fucking times than I would like to admit. This situation that I'm about to tell you about has happened at least 24 times to me over the last several years. Probably even more than that. Tons of times. And so what happened in that aisle? No, I didn't have a freaking breakdown in discipline and start devouring all that artificial, nasty fucking poison. I know that's what you were hoping I would say. That I just broke down and had a bunch of junk food or something like that right in the middle of the aisle like a savage just pouring that shit in my mouth. That's not what happened. Now, I am human, or at least sort of freaking human, but I still have my discipline. I'll eat some things that we're normally not supposed to eat when I feel that I've earned it and deserved it. I'll also do it with a clear understanding in my freaking mind, you know, the effect that it's going to have on me physically, but even more the effect it's going to have on me mentally if I do have those foods that we know we're not supposed to be eating. But sometimes I'll still do it here and there when I fucking earned it, though. That's the part you need to understand. But like I said, I'll also understand the fucking consequences and understand what it takes to reverse the negative impact of that so-called reward of some junk food or shitty foods I'm not supposed to be having. Because shit is not equal going in as it is going out. How long does it take for you to eat a piece of pizza or a nasty piece of freaking cake? You could probably wolf that shit down in like a minute or two. But let me tell you, you cannot just think that a minute or two extra on the treadmill or even 10 minutes or 20 minutes extra on the treadmill is going to make up for that piece of pizza or piece of cake or whatever, that piece of shit you just ate. It's not an equal one-for-one trade-off. A regular slice of pizza can be anywhere from 285 calories, like 400 calories or even more, depending on the shit you're putting on it. You know, it's going to take you a shitload longer to burn that off than the 2 minutes it took to eat that shit. So just think, oh, I'll spend a little extra time in the gym tomorrow. It's not that freaking simple. That's not going to cut it. And when you do finally burn the extra 300 calories in that piece of pizza or more or whatever it is. You know, was that all fat and carbs you burned? Probably not. It's not going to be the ideal amount. Your body's going to latch onto that garbage because it hasn't had it in so long. So fuck it. Starting to sound like, seem like pizza is maybe not the best idea in the world, or those cheap meals and cheap foods and all that other shit. Anyway, what the hell was I talking about? I don't even remember. I got off topic there for a second. So what was I talking about? Anyway, yeah, I was talking about the grocery store aisle, and I got into that whole little sidetrack about pizza and all this other stuff. Basically, one bad food kills a good meal. One bad meal kills an entire day. One bad day kills an entire week. One bad long weekend, extended weekend, kills a whole fucking month for you to dig out of that. Just keep that in mind when you think about, can I have a cheat meal? Should I have a cheat meal? Or are cheat meals allowed? Are cheat foods allowed? Fuck that. We're not cheaters. We're not cheating. So anyway, so I'm going through the grocery store aisle, right? That's where I left off. Or I started, didn't even get started. Pay attention. So yeah, I'm in the grocery store aisle, and I see that person number one we're going to get into, or any of those people. I'm going to explain to all the different people too in a second. Don't be one of those people. And I swear it's happened in the exact same grocery store, in this exact fucking aisle, many times. I'm not even exaggerating. The exact aisle, the same spot. It's happened with several different people. And other places also, but grocery store seems to be the most common. So don't be that person I run into in the fucking grocery store aisle. There are three types of them. Three types that I run into all the time, several times. Don't be one of these three people. Grocery store person number one. Behind door number one is grocery store freaking person number one. This is the person that I call failure to launch person. The failure to launch person. This is the saddest of the three people that I'm gonna talk to you about today. This is the person who I've previously met maybe once or twice before in the past, maybe at the gym or at a street fair or at some speaking presentation that I did. You know, this is the person telling me they needed Peak Physique's help to change their life. They hate the way they look. They're sad, lonely, depressed. Their husband or wife or goat or whatever doesn't look at them the same way anymore. It doesn't have that fucking twinkle in their eye when they look at them anymore. Their kids are embarrassed of them and tell them not to get out of the car when they drop them off at school. They hide behind all their family members in the family photos at the holidays so they're not seen. And that's even if they even showed up to those family holidays. They pretend to be sick or injured during the big events like Christmas parties and work functions and even freaking weddings. You know, they're 40 pounds overweight. They've hit rock bottom. They're afraid to go to the gym. They're intimidated by the gym. They have anxiety. They have nowhere else to turn. They are on the fucking verge of giving up and ready to just accept this feeling that they have and this lifestyle for the rest of their life. They are ready to change their life. They need some fucking Peak Freakness in their life. They are begging to be accepted into our program, saying they will do whatever it takes. They're ready to make the change. They're ready to make the leap. You know, they're ready. They're sick and tired of living in depression and fucking misery. They sometimes even might pay for the program in advance, up front. They will be at Peak Physique Bootcamp early Monday morning. Monday morning comes, and that motherfucker doesn't show up. We immediately reach out to them, but we get no response. And, you know, maybe that we think maybe, oh, they're just going to come to the PM session. They missed the morning sessions. Nighttime, nope, they're not there either. We follow up with them the next day. We call them. We text them. We email them. We fucking Facebook message them. We send out a fucking smoke signal. We'll knock on the fucking door of their house because this person is in desperate need of our help. And that is what our job is to help as many people as possible. We're starting to get worried about this person that we barely even freaking know. Then what happens? I go down the Greek yogurt aisle in the grocery store. I run into this person number one, the failure to launch person, 6 months later, and they're no longer 40 pounds overweight. It's more now like, 60 or 75 or even more pounds overweight. It fucking crushes me knowing that if they would have just shown up on that Monday fucking morning or answered the damn phone and just responded to a fucking text, then when I have seen them 6 months later, they could have already lost that 40 pounds. They could have been that they were initially carrying and even freaking more. I could have been seeing them 6 months later on their Facebook pics on vacation in the fucking Bahamas wearing their fucking thong bikini. But instead, they're dipping their head down the aisle, looking up towards my direction, the corner of their eye through their eyelids with that look of shame, hoping that I didn't spot them. These situations really fucking crush me knowing what could have been. And this is person number one, the failure to launch. If you have any questions, comments, or want to tell me to shut the fuck up, then just put it in the comments and whatever. So that's person number one in the grocery store. Then there's person number two. This is the one I call the fucking roller coaster. Person number two, the roller coaster. This is the person who came into the gym on a trial and maybe and signed up, you know, to continue beyond the trial or something and has been training at Peak Physique for a few months. They started out just like person number one, but they actually showed up on that Monday morning and their life was instantly changed. They lost like 4 or 5 pounds in their first freaking week. After 3 months, they're down like 25 pounds. After 5 months, they're down like 40 pounds. Then they caught that fucking bug. They caught that bug. That bug of, I got this. I could do this on my own. Sometimes they catch that bug after only 4 weeks. Sometimes it takes 5 or 6 months for them to catch a bug. But the outcome of this bug is the same and it's fucking devastating. They will go, they'll try to go to the gym and try it on their own and maybe take some Zumba classes at a fucking commercial gym or some body pump or some other shit at the commercial gym. You know, they're leaving in the best shape of their lives and they still have some work to do, but they've gotten some great results in a short amount of time, but they're ready to go do it on their own. They're one of those. They caught that bug of doing it on your own. And they go to a gym, they try out some of those classes, that Zumba class, whatever the fuck it's called. The body pump. They take the body pump class and all this other, maybe a spin class or something. And it fucking blows. And it blows fucking hard. They're surrounded by a bunch of whiny, annoying assholes who don't know, they don't know them, and they don't ever wish to get to know them. The instructor is up front doing the workout with them, just screaming into some little fancy McDonald's microphone, screaming some dumb shit into the microphone about some grapevine or some footwork they're gonna do over a little step aerobics class with their little leg warmers on or some other freaking nonsense. They try it a few more times and it fucking sucks more and more each time. They give it up in a few weeks, or they get to give it a try for a few weeks. It never gets better. It never gets fun. It's never different. It's always the same shit, the same lame instructors, same annoying fucking members. So they stop going to the classes and they decide, you know what? I'm just going to work out with my friend in the gym. We're going to work out together. We're going to motivate each other. We're going to be partners. It's going to be awesome. We're going to get in the best shape of our lives. We're going to be on that beach in the Bahamas in our fucking thongs in a few months. And that lasts about another 2 weeks. Their friend keeps calling them and canceling on them because they got to get their fucking toenails done, or they need to take another rest day because it's Grandparents' Day, or it's Flag Day, or it's National Fucking Cupcake Day in Switzerland. And, you know, and then when their friend cancels, this person number two from the grocery store aisle, they don't make it to the gym either. Their person cancels, so they just say, all right, I'm just not going to go either. They lose the motivation. So now that person's going to give up on their, they're going to give up on their friend. They're like, you know what? I don't need those Zumba classes. I don't need my friend as a partner. I'm going to do this shit by myself. I know I can do it by myself. They try it by themselves. They're bored out of their mind. There's no fun. There's no excitement. There's no community. There's no culture. There's no fucking results. And now it's 6 months later, and I run into them in that Greek yogurt aisle opposite the donuts and desserts, and person number two is back to square fucking one, back to where they started before their months at peak physique. All their hard work, their time, their effort, their money, fucking wasted. It's now 1 year from the start of this roller coaster journey. You know, and they could have been at their ultimate dream goal body by now because they were on their way after 4, 5, 6 months or whatever. And they caught that bug of trying to do it themselves. That's why we call it that roller coaster person. And they're in that grocery store aisle checking out the fucking little donuts and the little Susie's cakes or whatever the hell that shit is called. Person number two dips their head down in shame, but they make eye contact with me. Different than person number one. They actually peek up, make eye contact instead of pretending they don't see me. They even make eye contact and engage in conversation maybe. They say they're so pissed or embarrassed or ashamed how they let themselves fucking go and lost all the fucking awesome gains and results that they got at peak. That's person number two, the freaking roller coaster. Person number one was the failure to launch. Person number two is the roller coaster. Then we come up with person number three. This person is called the true blue, the about face. That's what they're called. This one is like person number one was confused and maybe who's, you know, person number one was confused, maybe not ready. They were scared, shy, crying for help. So that's the sad one. Person number two has what it takes and then self-sabotage themselves for whatever reason because of whatever outside forces or influences that might have thrown them off track and influenced them in a different direction, you know, but they know what it takes. They know what needs to get done. They understand it's a long journey, but they're willing to start it all over again, possibly. You know, and maybe this time try to fucking do it right and make it the long-term change in their life. Then there's person number three, the true blue about face, the fucking 180 person number three. This person was just like number one when they started, except they showed up on that Monday morning. They actually showed up on that morning. They were just like person number two, except they didn't stop after a few months. Person number three went through some ups and downs maybe, but always kept their fucking eyes on the prize. They achieved unheard of success, results, transformations, both physically and mentally. They've completely changed their life for the better, and then fucking boom, the true blue evolution happens. The about face, the fucking 180. This person number three was like person number one, but they completely evolved into an awesome, positive, motivating leader, and bam, they hit the fucking 180. They completely changed towards everyone around them. They now look different, so now they start acting different. It's now like a in a sour, fucking miserable way. I don't know if it's the demons from the past that they weren't able to grow beyond when they physically evolved and they got better physically and mentally, and they weren't able to escape those demons in their head from the past or whatever about the way they used to live, and it's still eating away at them. I'm not sure what it is, or if this was just truly who the fuck they were all along, and they were just waiting till they got to that stage where they could just break out of that shell and just be a fucking douchebag. Maybe the years, I don't know, maybe the years of the depression or whatever else was always boiling up inside of them, and now they let the success and the physical transformation get to their freaking head, and they become exactly the type of person they used to despise. That stuck-up, fucking nose up in the air, better than everyone else type of person. That's person number three. They turn their back on everyone around them. They slash the fucking wrist of the hand that helped them and the hand that was holding them, treating them like a little baby when they needed it, like a little infant when they were walking in, like person number one in their time of need, rather than appreciate that person. They fucking slash that wrist of that person. They backstab every person that helped them along the way. They talk shit. They gossip. They fucking lie like a scumbag. So I've come across this person several times in the fucking grocery store aisles. It's funny shit. It's always in the grocery store aisle. It's always in the dessert aisle. And, you know, this person makes eye contact, but first they dip their head down like person number one, then they peek up like person number two, and then they do the about face and walk away like person number three in the other direction, like they're in the face of a stranger or even their fucking enemy. So I'm still studying and researching literally this behavior to figure out the causes of all three of these grocery store people in this grocery store aisle. Humans are just as fucking fascinating as they are freaking crazy. But really, you can't blame them. You can't blame any of these three people. We've all gone through some shit in our lives. We've all gone through some adversity, some shit that maybe haunts us from before or whatever. And, you know, some of us a lot more than others, different levels of traumatization or whatever the hell the word is. If that's even a word, I don't know. I don't give a damn. It's Steve says, it's now a fucking word. So people deal with different changes they come about. Even though if it's a positive change, they might deal with that positive change negatively for whatever reason. I don't know why. Trying to figure it out, but I think it's something to do with that. And they deal with those positive changes. They almost don't know how to deal with success and positivity because they're just so used to the depression and negativity and sourness and miserable fucking people around them, and they turn their back on everyone. So I'm going to finish with this. All three of those type of people, we are still here to help you. We are still here for you. I'm a United States Marine, and I swore an oath to defend the people of this country against enemies, both foreign and domestic, and I've made it my duty, my obligation, and my main fucking mission and purpose in life to help people just like all three of you in that fucking grocery store aisle, no matter what. Literally, their life depends on it, and they need our help immediately. It gets to the point where our team at Peak wants to help some of these people more than they even want to help themselves. No matter what level they've gotten to, we are here for you. So don't become one of those three freaking people. And if you become one of them, it's not too late to get your shit together and get back on track to where you should be and you know you should be and not be one of those douchebags. Especially person number three. Peak Physique is exactly here for freaks like you, and we're not going anywhere. We are not going any fucking where. If anything, we are just exploding. We are taking over. We are here to help you all over the place, and we're going to give you more and more opportunities to be helped. You are all welcome back to the Peak Freak family. Although you might have turned your back on the people around you and even turned your back on yourself, us Peak Freaks will not turn our back on you, and we are still here to help you. So obviously, no excuses. If you have any questions or comments, you can put them down here in the bottom. And I see a bunch of things getting popped. That's probably that psycho. Anyway, if you have any questions, comments, put them in the bottom. And I'll talk to you guys later.